canceling it. Let's continue. What we are saying is sickness is illegal. And let me show you, when Adam fell, we always want to begin at the beginning. Adam was not designed to live with sickness and disease. God has never intended for any human being to have sickness in him. Sickness is evil. You know what evil is? Evil is everything bad that messes human life. It is evil. And evil was found in who? Lucifer. Can I show you something? Let's go. That's what God was telling this man, chapter number 28. Of the look of the book of Ezekiel. I'm saying sickness is evil, and evil doesn't come from God. Verse 15. This one is talking about Lucifer. Thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day that thou wast created till iniquity was found in you. Now, other version talks about evil. He is the source of all sickness and disease. The devil. When God told Adam, do not eat the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, sickness was there. In chapter number 2, verse 9 of Genesis, he says, there are three different trees God created in the Garden of Eden. The one that comes from the ground, which is for food, the Bible says. Then number 2, tree of life. And then he says, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Then in verse 16 and 17, he tells them, of all trees you can partake of its fruit, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, do not. And the day you take of it, you shall surely die. When God was speaking to Adam, those statements, Adam was so strong in his body. Adam was so energetic. You know his body. What do I compare his body to? Mtu mwenye ameenda gym mpaka mwili imejenga. Although, you know, you can have that kind of body sickness ikikuja unaisha tu mara moja. If you don't know the light. I mean, Adam, my goodness, never knew sickness. He never even thought of it. But the day he ate that fruit, that is the day evil entered him. It entered his spirit, because whatever enters your spirit will get hold of your body. What enters your spirit will get hold of you. You cannot be sick physically if you're not sick spiritually. You cannot die physically if you have not died spiritually. If you eat this fruit, you will surely. That death is separation from God. When you are separated from God, the devil can bring in anything. Until Jesus died on the cross, the devil legally could place sickness on anybody on the face of the earth. Who has never fallen sick? That's like, there's nobody who has never lied. You know that? Nobody has never fallen sick. In fact, even Mtoto Mdogo kama huyu, as young as the child is, unaambiwa, kuna kitu itafanyika kwake, unaanza kusikia fever, sijui nini. I mean, sickness is evil. And for formation, sickness is demons that manifest in human body. It is science that is trying to tell us. Science is giving
demon so many names. Flu, cold, stomachache, ulcer. Those words are not in the Bible. Have you seen anywhere? Malaria. What else? All those, I don't know it. Has it been written here? The ones who wrote the Bible, I've never heard that vocabulary. This Bible is inspired by God. And what is written inside here is not from the mind of man. It's from the mind of God. And they've never presented to us malaria. The challenge is you are taught malaria in school. If you begin feeling some fever, some bitterness in your mouth, know that that is, even before you, that symptom comes, you are being prepared for. And you have never understood, when they were speaking to you is when they are creating in you. They are saying, yes. Can you give us the symptoms of malaria? The teacher, may God help biology teachers like Mama Fever, who are teaching some of those sickness. Are you hearing? Yes. Dysentery. When the stomach goes like this, mtoto hajawahi sikia. I think Alpha is also celebrating with me. Why was he quiet before? He's getting the anointing, might be. Look at that. It is not in the Bible. And the way you believe it, my God. Unajua daktari alisema. You know the doctor said. The doctor said. I only have how many months? It is like a judge who has given his judgment that now you only have how many days? 3 months. 3. And you are just... It is not in the Bible. That evil began happening in the body of people when man was delinked from the word of God. You see, when Adam was chased from the Garden of Eden, he could no longer hear the word of. What could he depend now? Not the word of God. Not the word of God. That is why lie. You know what lies? There are some lies that we have received as truth. And we have lived with it for years. Because this truth of the gospel cannot be accessed. God cannot speak to anybody. Now people are forming their own language, philosophies, ideologies. And then you go and whatever you learned from nursery to university. Thank God, at least you have some job somewhere. You have job, I know. Because of what you studied in school. That's not bad. But many of this information is not very healthy for human living. But we are told, we have been told a lot of things. A lot. We have been taught. Because man was disconnected from God. Nothing comes without word. Or words. Can I repeat that? There is nothing that comes without words. The words that you speak is what will create in you what you're speaking. As you're painting the picture of what happened, somebody is seeing it clearly. So
Not even wakati tunaambiwa vile magonjwa symptoms of sickness. Sikuna mali tujifunza kuhusu sickness kwa biology, I think. Yeah, kuna mali. Now that you are taught, being taught the body parts, and they are told all type of sickness that can enter different parts of the body, and they are told this is. Why can't we be told how the eternal life, divine life, is entering every fiber of your being?